Okay, so in our current lesson, we start, let's say, creating a structure in our data that we'll later on use to generate the HTML in our page. Okay, so let's start by adding those titles in and then those ones. So I would say it will be a collection that holds other collections. So let's start firstly with the data that will help us generate all of this. So if we go to the skills and then we got skills JSON, this is the legend and we got item lists, heart trophy and book. I think I will use this heart trophy and book as types because they're already here, so I don't have to think about them too much. So what do I do now? Legend, maybe skill list after. No, legend ends here. So this, yeah, that's where a legend ends. So I'll add a comma and I'll do a property skill list. Okay, this would be more like a skill list, skill type list maybe. Skill type, because skills list will be inside the skill type, right? So again, this would be an array and inside it we'll have different objects. Well, different data objects, but same structure objects. This will be a type, maybe a type, and let's call it frontend. Okay, and then another comma here. And then what does it do, this one? Well, it is frontend, and on top of that, it also has a collection of other ones. I think I'll include the color inside each skill. So let's see, this would be now skill list. Let's add a comma here and this would be a collection itself of objects with type heart. And then label, and then let's see what we do for label. Usually I do like this, and now let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10. Okay, so 10 to start with. Let's add a comma here and then select this part. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1. So I duplicated 4 times, 1, 4 plus 1, 5, then I selected 5 and duplicated those ones, and now I got 10. And the reason why I typed R there is because now I can just go and double click and do HTML, CSS, JavaScript, double click, CSS, double click, JavaScript, okay, React Redux style components, React Redux styled components. Okay, and then I got sassless material UI SEO. Those are no longer hard, those are trophy. Where's the trophy? Come on, where's trophy? Copy it, style components. So we got 4 more, 1, 2, 3. Oh, and those are trophy. Sassless material UI SEO. Sassless material UI and SEO. Okay, so I can remove that comma, and I'm not yet going to remove this comma because I'm going to collapse that, so it's easy for me to select from this to this and duplicate twice. Now I've duplicated, which means I can collapse the very first one and this will be backend now. So for backend, we got pug, Node.js and Firebase. Pug, Node.js and Firebase. Again, this might differ for you, so feel free to update them with anything you want. However, don't be, let's say, cheap about it. Just add more. even if you just heard about it anyway. I don't, you want to play with this in a way that you'd stress a bit the implementation and the design. You might be looking to see if it breaks somewhere or if it doesn't behave properly. So do test out, do use maybe longer words than anything else and see if it just adapts well or not, right? Okay, so definitely those colors are not that representative for me. I could look some more into them. Some of them are, some of them aren't. So for the moment, until it's final, just go with it. Just play with it. Don't be too serious about it, right? Okay, so we got Git, Linux, REST, and MySQL. But this is no longer hard, it's trophy. Okay, so Firebase, Git, Linux, and then REST and MySQL. Okay, and then AWS, blockchain, and so on. But this is, what is it? It's book. Okay, so this is book. And then it's AWS Blockchain Elasticsearch, AWS Blockchain Elasticsearch, maybe separate, it doesn't matter, and one more, GraphQL. Cool. I can remove the comma from this one and expand it, and this would be what? Others. Okay, so others has Windows, Linux, Mac. There's Heart. Linux and Mac. It's actually Mac OS X, something like that. And then Jira, Agile, and REST. And REST again. Yeah, I don't know why I put REST here. But this would be Trophy already. So Jira, Agile. And instead of REST, because, yeah, I would just put Rally maybe. Rally is similar to Jira. Actually, I can even put one more, which is... Yeah, I forgot about it. And it's on the tip of my tongue. Anyway, I don't want to stress about it. It was similar to Jira. Right now, I'm missing the name of it. Yeah, maybe it's too late in the night. So let's leave it like it is right now. We got enough data, and this is, yeah, we got enough data. Which means right now we can start playing with it, right? Because we know that we got a skill type list inside our skills JSON as a property. Okay, so we got the data. I'm happy about it. Let's actually go back quickly to it. What we've done so far is we got the skill type list. I could say skill types. I prefer to use singular. And list or collection or something, table, whatever. Something that kind of gives me information that's a collection. Now there is a reason behind it, because I'm trying to find the good logic and not just learn because somebody else before me has done it, so therefore I should do it the same. I ask questions, and if something sounds good, then I do it like others have done it before me. Otherwise, I ask questions and I can take decisions on my own. That's what makes me a good developer, and that's something that could make you a good developer. Now, what happens when you have a big team of people coming from all around the world and all of them speaking English? Some of them are very good, some of them, let's say, in the middle, and some of them less good. So, well, people are people, so you have to accept them as they are. However, I've encountered so many times decisions naming folders more like components with capital plural, and then JavaScript. Why would you name a folder JavaScript when it has more files into it or multiple folders with multiple files and so on, and you don't name it JavaScript. Why do you name it JavaScript and not JavaScript when you name components? Why do you name CSS and not CSSs, right? Or then you might run into trouble, like sometimes I encounter this a lot from Italians, child and childs, which is child and children, right? Again, because some people don't know very well English, you might encounter in these scenarios and childrens, right? Again, it's child and children. And so many mouses instead of mice, right? So you get into those scenarios, and in order to avoid them, there's a very easy solution. Pick either the singular or either the plural and just stick with it. Put everywhere singular or put everywhere plural, and that's it. Now, if you think about using the singular, because that's the most known, let's say, form of a word in English, then you can just pick that and stick with it. And think about, let's say, when you say component, well, inside it, it's a collection of type, whatever it's inside, it's a type component. The entity is it's a component, right? The entity inside it. Now, a collection, by definition, has 0, 1, or more elements, which satisfies whatever we are about to do. Again, what happens when you say components and you have no component into it? Well, you could say 0 components, but what happens when you have only 1 component into it? Why would you name it components when it only has 1 component? Again, if you think about just using singular, and that singular defines the type, it defines the entity, whatever it's inside, it's of this type, then you no longer have to think about it. It's just a collection with 0, 1, or more entities inside it. Cool. And that means we can go and start iterating this list and have the data printed on our screen in the next lesson. So in the next lesson, we get to finish the section style, do the proper colors, paddings, spacings, and so on. Add the joke, why not? Let's see in the next one.